Hello again, my most amazing artists. Today, we are coming back to work on our stop-motion animation films. If you recall from last week, we talked about creating a storyboard and brainstorming ideas for one of our stop-motion animation films. Remember, there are four types of stop-motion animation that we can do for this project. The first two are pixelation and claymation, which require you to work with one another partner. The other ones are object stop motion and paper cutouts. We choose one of those four, and we're going to explore this Chrome extension today. If you Google search stop motion animator when you are signed into Chrome, you will be able to see this as the first link that pops up. When you click on this, if you haven't already clicked the button that says add to Chrome, you need to go ahead and do that. And then when it's ready, you should just be able to launch the app. Let's see what that looks like. Here on my desk, I have some items that I'm going to be using to create my stop motion film. In this case, I'm just going to make a very simple object stop motion movie just because I don't want this video to be super long so that you have a lot of time to work. What we're going to do is explore what each one of these buttons on our screen does. So we're going to be looking at, wrong side, these buttons over here in order to create this stop motion. So I'm going to begin by placing an object where I want it to appear on screen. Make sure my other ones are out of the frame. Everything else is out of the way. Lining it up where I think it needs to go. Okay. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to click the button that says capture. Okay. This button just takes a photo. Another thing I can do besides hitting capture is if I have this screen open, I can just hit my space bar and it should also take a picture. Now, after you've taken your first photo, you are going to think about how much you need to move that item to create that sense of motion. You can notice on my screen here that there is a double image. Right here, I have what's known as an onion skin. This is a layering effect. An onion skin just shows us where the item was in the previous shot and helps us realign or move our items in order to create that sense of motion so that it looks like a real video. Remember, when we're moving our items, they need to move in very small increments in order to seem realistic. So I'm gonna take another photograph. Notice how the picture has changed. I'm gonna bring in another item here. I'm gonna set this here. And I'm actually going to adjust this one as well. Take another photo, adjust my items, take another photo, take another. Keeping my hands out of the shot when I take that photo is really going to be tricky, but you gotta do it because you can, and be sure you're reviewing your photos as you're working because it's really easy to make a mistake and then go all the way back through your movie and realize that, my whole hand was in one of my pictures and now I can't undo just that one photo. I have to undo everything and that would be terrible. Turning my items one more time and then I'll have a move around my screen a little bit. So I'm gonna turn, and remember, we're moving in really small. This is a really big increment of movement, okay? But I'm gonna go ahead and do that because I don't wanna waste your time. So I'm gonna move them in slightly larger increments than you probably should. Take my photo, move my items again. And then, there we go. Take another photo. Uh-oh, did you see how my hand got in that shot? Undo. Try again. last ones here. And then I put them off the screen. Whoops, completely out of frame. And then maybe I would take a picture of my credits, something like that. Now, I can go back at any point and I can hit the play button to see what it is I've made. That doesn't look too bad. Also, if I go down here, I can change my frame rate. So I can slow it down and decide whether that looks better. I can also speed it up. And decide which one of those things is going to work best for me. Remember, if you slow it down though, you will have to take a few more photos than you would otherwise have to take. So now, at this point, if I would like to, I can create audio. So if I want, I can actually just play a sound in another tab, or I can record this audio myself. So I want to make sure that I have it at the speed that I want it before I do this. Boop, 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 ba-da-da-boop. Right, that was a really simple, silly sound, but let's check it out. Boop, 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 ba-da-da-boop. Right, and then that could be my whole movie. So at that point, if I was at my time requirement of 20 to 30 seconds, I would go ahead and hit save. And then I would give this a name, and in this case, I'm going to name it Color Block Movie, right? And I would save that, and what that's going to do is automatically download to your Chromebook. So I really hope that you enjoy playing around with this stop motion animator extension and that you decide to make more movies once you get the hang of it. I hope you had a lot of fun doing this project. See you later.